get money? Oh, I just want to be here. Oh, you look so fabulous.
Get away from me, you jackals. Go away. Don't make me go Pompeii on your teasters.
So, Barry, where does Ken fit into the picture?
You know, he doesn't really. He was a very minor figure, hardly worth mentioning. I mean, I have trouble even remembering his name sometimes. Was it Ben or Len or something like that? Oh, no, is it him? I'm sorry, Ken. No, not the Italian bomb. Mommy!
That was just a little hive quake.
I knew that. We would do for one.
You, Ken, and Vanessa. So, was it a love triangle?
No, I'm a bee and she's a human.
Ken's a human.
Barely.
No triangle, then. How about a rhombus? Maybe a trapezoid?
Can we change the subject?
What's the matter, Barry? All this talk of a love triangle got you bent out of shape?
Triangle? Shape? Huh? How about that, Hal? Tell me you got that on camera. That one's going on the Emmy reel. Did everyone see how I made a witty?
Do you think I don't see what you're up to?
I'm sorry?
You're trying to steal my girl.
Whoa, dude, just hanging out. What's that in your hand?
Italian Vogue.
Mamma mia, that's a lot of pages.
It's a lot of ads.
Remember what Van said? Why is your life any more valuable than mine?
Well, that's exactly what I'm remembering. You will! Yes! Stay still! Stay still! What up?
Hi. Watch your wings! Watch your wings! Oh.
You little! Stop moving! You little! Stop moving! Stop moving! Enough!
Hey! I'm good. That was close.
Arrivederci! Stay still! Stay still! Stay still!
Hi. Is that all you got? You missed. Lucky shot.
Focus, Ken. Stop moving! Stay still! Stay still! Stay still! Stay still! Hey, you little!
Can't we settle this up? Oh! Is that all you got? Can't we settle this over a drink?
Stop moving!
Can't we settle this over a drink?
Oh, sure.
This one's on me. Oh, who's your daddy? Enough! Stop moving! Stop moving! Enough! Enough!
lucky shot. You missed. That is gonna leave a mark. Better luck next time. Oh no, Liquinet with Permahold. A favorite of old ladies everywhere.
That's right, B. And you're about to have a bad hair day.
Hey!
You little... Stop moving! You little... Stay still! Enough! Stop moving! Stop moving! Oh, who's your daddy? Enough! Stop moving! You little! You little! Stop moving!
Hi. You missed. Hi.
Ken, what are you doing?
Nothing.
You are in big trouble, mister.
And I want to thank you all for this honor. I'll never forget you. You like me. You really like me.
Excuse me? Can we get back to the story, please? I was just about to get to the good part.
Good part?
I'm all ears.
Okay. Have you ever heard of Operation Burspur?
Burspur?
Burspur.
No.
Well, I'm not surprised. Burspur was the code name for the plot that Montgomery was actually hatching during the honey crisis.
With a name like Burspur? It's ridiculous. Let's take some callers. We'll see who else knows about this so-called Operation Burspur. Call our toll-free number, 1-800...
Wait a second, don't take callers now. Look, if you start taking callers, I'm not going to tell you about Burspur.
Barry, I am a truth seeker. And as a truth seeker, I want my audience to know all the facts. For example, you were a cocoon wetter growing up, were you not?
Hey, how did you...
Thank you, Miss Chung, for having us on the show. We're very proud of Barry.
That's my son there. You know, he was going to be a stirrer like his old man.
Oh, stop it! You're embarrassing him! He was never going to be a stirrer!
You don't have any friends, do you?
Not a one.
Okay, I'll tell you about Burspur.
Is that the latest on Operation BRSPR?
Burspur? Yes, sir.
Are you making a joke?
No, sir. It is Burspur.
Well, keep that under lock and key. And laser.
Laser? What's that smell? It smells delicious. Why, it's honey. Oh, how I've missed a taste of the good stuff. Now, one lick won't hurt anyone. Ah, it's awful. It looks just like honey, but it tastes like Brussels sprouts. Operation Burspur. Brussels sprouts! Yuck, I gotta get that taste of Brussels sprouts out of my mouth.
Well, well, well. Looky here, guys. It's our little B-boy come home to roost.
Yeah, roost.
First of all, bees don't roost. Second, is this really the best work you could come up with? And third, do any of you have any minty gum? I can't get the Brussels sprouts taste out of my mouth.
Yeah, that's a big boss's plan. Don Montgomery is going to turn the entire world's supply of honey into that stuff. It looks like honey, feels like honey, smells like honey, tastes like Brussels sprouts.
Oh, the horror, the horror.
That includes the stuff you bees have, too. With the stockpiles he has underground, he'll corner the market. Everyone will have to come to him. He'll be the wealthiest man in the world.
Yeah, and what do you hornets get out of the deal?
What else? All the candy we can carry. Enough to become kings ourselves. He keeps it all in his special briefcase.
Really generous of you guys to tell me what's going on here. I suppose now is where you say, but you'll never get out of here to use that information, right?
Yeah, something like that. It's nothing personal, you understand. It's just something that we hornets do. It wouldn't look right otherwise. Thanks for understanding. Get him, boys!
Wait. So, Barry, what did you do then?
Well, Jeanette, I did what any other red-blooded American bee would do when facing a threat like this. I shared the wealth.
Honey, 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 I love you. Very soon, thanks to you, I will be a wealthy, wealthy man.
What?
What? No! No! You're not Brussels sprouts! No! Benson!
You are cleared for landing.